Now I'll give you over to the lovely princess, and whose line is it? Anypony.
Four people, you come up, you dance like monkeys, we laugh. That's pretty much how it works. We've got categories, so normally it's like, you know, everything's made up and the points don't matter, which is sort of true. Except that our judges are here. We've got, you know, Sweebell, Sulu, and my lovely sister Luna, who will be judging you on how funny you are and how much the audience is laughing. At the end of the four regular rounds, we will basically bring up the four funniest people to dance extra for us. It's not making you dance like monkeys, it's fun. So without any more delay, I'm just going to pull up four people. So you have to come on. Obnoxious noise. You know what that noise is? Yeah, that's right. And then you switch off with your partner and keep going, and we'll time you, and if it's a little low or you run out of time, we'll cut in, be obnoxious.
Oh, yeah.
So big voices, keep looking at microphones, project, once you hear it. Yeah, okay. All right. So you guys are Everfree. Yeah, you're trying to look for your panel. Whenever you're ready. You're trying to look for your panel. Okay, ready? Go.
Where's the panel?
Man, it could be there, but I'm not sure. What do you think?
Let's spend time together.
That ended in a question.
The audience has spoken.
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
Taylor,
you're
something.
drinking something.
Do you know where I can find a milk tank?
What do you want in it?
Do you sell straws?
Do you need one?
Do I need one?
Maybe.
Do you know where I can find some straws?
I don't know. Are they near the napkins?
Are they near the napkins?
Repetition means no.
Napkins?
Straws?
Milkshakes?
Soda?
Muffins?
Superhero number one. pants. That's, it was pants, right?
Yeah.
The cat has pants. Okay, crisis.
No pants.
No what?
Problem solved!
lovely bachelorettes to choose from. We haven't told them who they are. We haven't told you who they are. So they're going to act out their rules, and it's going to be funny because he's going to have to try and guess. And so are you. So we've got bachelorette number one, bachelorette number two, and bachelorette number three. So I'm sure our bachelor knows how this works. Ask him consecutively. Whatever. I'm just going to walk away now and do this.
You'll let me take care of this. Fantastic.
Okay, so like bachelorette number one. So being royalty, you know, being gay, let's be real. I've been with a lot of ponies, and well, they've wanted to be with me. I just sort of pretend to be interested, but at the gala last year, I did meet a very interesting mare who proceeded to make me feel dirtier than I've ever felt in my entire life. She was quite lovely. It's a shame I don't know her anymore. But I was wondering, what would you do if I was to take you to the gala?
Well, young whippersnapper, I think I spend most of the day near the apples and all the other nice confectionaries we have, and I'd be very helpful to you because I'd tell you just how wrong they are for you and which ones you should actually eat. And that will get you a nice, healthy diet so you can dance all night.
Bachelor number two, same question.
Honestly, I think that I would probably have to ask if I could film some of your infamous transgressions, because I know many little fillies who may need a lesson in kindness, because my children, there has been some bullying going on, and I need to teach them what happens when no one tells you how to treat people fairly.
I can hear you booing at home. And why not? That's for number three, same question.
Well, I don't think my... I just stayed up all night and did catering, you know? Because sometimes you just want to import new goods, like especially like delicious cupcakes from the bakery. And I really have to say, with the other twins, they are a handful.
Interesting, interesting. I have zero idea who any of you are. Fantastic. Yeah, I know, I'm doing great. Okay, let me think here. So, being, you know, royal and myself, I've always looked to my rest of my family, and they all sort of, you know, they have a little, you know, inside joke. You may not know about this, people at home, but they kind of belittle me a little bit. That's why I feel the way I do sometimes, so dark and cold. And, yeah, blue and miserable by myself. Yes. Yeah, so I was just wondering, if we were having like a really, really tough day, what would you suggest we do just to make it all sunshine and rainbows? That's your number one.
Well, I think we should go outside in the sunshine and just look at all the trees and the life that's put into the trees. And just really feel a part of that life and know that we are important to the life of these trees.
It's raining.
Same question, I'm still thinking about her.
Well, there are different kinds of bad days. Some you can be brought out of by reminding yourself of all the positive things in the world. New possibilities. You discover every day there's just a new enlightenment to discover. Other days you just need to be reminded that it could always get worse. You could wake up and the last thing you remember is a bunch of little 10-year-olds who think they know how to run your love life better than you do.
Oh, well, running the bakery is rough and hard. I mean, I have to still go to work. I can't go home and look after you. What would my husband say about that?
You're married?
Who'd you pick out for me?
If any of my students are listening, I do not endorse this activity.
This is scandalous.
All right, give them a moment.
question.
Of course. Okay, so last one, because I need a neon sign as to who you. They're ponies, right? Well, okay, I watched the show, believe it or not, so I've got this thing with me, but. Okay. If the two of us were to spend the rest of our lives together, and we were going to protect Equestria with our element of love, what would our element of harmony be and why? I mean, have you seen Shining Armor and Cadence? No offense, if that guy can do it, so can I. Come on. No, it's a tough one, it really is. That's why I get asked the questions and you answer them.
Well, I've been around for a long time, so I guess I would say EXP. And I really don't actually know a lot about you, but I won't be around for that much longer. So I think the best thing that you can have for us is hair gel.
I'm not sure how to talk that, honestly. I think that my element, personally, would be hope, because I specifically chose to work with children because in the often quoted, often used for television episodes, I believe the children are our future. And as for you, I would hope that it was anything but being a robot, because my last husband did not support my decision to go back to school and become a teacher, and I had to put him down because it turned out he was a robot.
Desire things, my two little twins. It's so weird that they just became a unicorn and a Pegasus, because I'm an earth pony, you know? It's like that's magic to me, and I just really love magic.
That was beautiful. I'll try to remember that.
Okay, Bachelor.
Who did you pick for me?
So let me get this straight. You like bananas?
Because she said, like, outside and be with the trees, and then there was the joke about, you know, death and stuff. It's like, wow, that's actually kind of sick. You people are sick.
She is a little.
Yeah.
Number two?
I have absolutely no idea.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Yes! This is why he's still single. Number three.
Mrs. Cake, get out of here.
Yeah. Fantastic, give them a huge round of applause.
Yeah.
maybe a little bit, small explosion.
Oh, okay, and come over here. You're my freeliner, you get to say anything.
Oh boy.
Yeah. The rest of you, on the other hand, I'm gonna give you a personality and 2 lines. That's all you get. Is this called 2 liners? So basically your role is, we're gonna give you the role of, you're writing a My Little Pony fanfiction. And you've run out of inspiration, you're at that point, so writer's block. You know what fanfiction is, right? Okay, maybe. Okay, no, trust me, I did this once a couple years ago, and I asked, I was like, you're fanfiction, right? Fanfiction, I'm like, what's a fanfiction?
What's this fanfiction?
Get off the stage, sir. How are you going to panel on fanfiction? Anyway, okay, so you're writing a fanfiction, you hit your writer's block. So you come and you find these people, and you're like, I'm going to get some inspiration. So you come and come across Big Mac.
Yep.
Yep. Yep.
Yep.
Okay. And, I can't decide which one you want me to get to. Your two lines are Well, Hold On, Apple Barbecue. And Yeehaw! And you're Pinkie Pie. And your two lines are, well, duh, and I'm gonna jiffy, I'm a pastry chef. That's more of a companion, right? Right? Yeah. Can you guys know your lines? Can you say, man? Okay, you got yours. What about you? Well, hold on, apple barbecue. Yeehaw! Got it?
Yeah.
Well, duh. Okay. So whenever you're ready, you can fish your writer.
Okay.
Take it away.
Just add some shipping.
So the audience, they got it all for you.
All right. Once upon a time, there was Pony. It was Big Man.
Yep.
You have Applejack and Pinkie Pie. Applejack and Pinkie Pie.
Big voice, big voice.
Big voice for Jack.
All right. Man voice. Okay. So, once upon a time, there was a pony named Big Mac. He was best pony in the world. So, one day, he had explosion and Applejack come to save the day.
Hold on, have a barbecue.
So they had small barbecue and tiny little crater explosion. And then Pinkie Pie had to jump in.
Well, duh.
Yeah. After that, they decided to fly spaceship for some reason.
Well, duh.
Yeah.
After they got to the moon, they decided there was nothing there. Why go to moon? I mean, it is small and vacant there. Why would you park in crater? What is wrong with you?
Yeehaw!
I'm not a gypsy, I'm a pastry chef.
So they decide to go to Gypsy, which is Pinkie Pie.
I'm not a gypsy, I'm a pastry chef.
You are pastry gypsy. Okay. So they go to Pastor Gypsy and they ask their fortune, and Applejack says,
yeah!
To which Big Mac responds,
nope.
Then they all have party and go back to Earth.
Well, duh!
Well, hold on, apple barbecue!
To go to convention.
Yeehaw!
Well, duh!
Convention is very nice. It has pretty lights. Everyone is there.
Well, duh!
Big Mac decided to fall over dead. He's gone.
Yeehaw!
Everyone cheer! I don't know why! So then Pinkie Pie uses pastry to try to revive. Pastry is successful! Applejack says...
Oh, throw it out at Apple Barbecue.
So they make barbecue at the Big Mac.
Okay, so I'm gonna be up to see.
I'll read something, and then one at a time, you will step forward, do something, ask something from the scene, and then step back to the line. And then you'll continue that until that particular scene that I've read out, either you guys have any ideas for it, or you run out of options, or I just thought you'd been talking about it for too long. And then I switch it, and I'll try to get through as many of them as I can until the time runs out. Right? Everyone knows what we're doing? Yeah? Okay, so first scene is the Russian basket ship.
Is that Alfion I hear? It's Spaz.
Spaz station. Russian Spaz station.
Okay, say the whole thing one more time.
The Russian Spaz station.
That was responsible. The BC Bronies were responsible for that, you guys. I know who exactly who did it. Alfion.
Is it
Make it your own. We don't want any canon characters or written letters. We want our own experiences and everything. So
That will be again tomorrow at 10:30, so get your letters in before tonight so I can screen them and read them tomorrow. Dear Princess, you can write to any of the four princesses. You don't have to write to me.
Luna, Cadence.
Family friendly.
Well, it's Barbara. Hey,
Merry Christmas.
Drinking something.
Do you know where I can find a milk tank?
What do you want in it?
Do you sell straws?
Do you need one?
Do I need one?
Maybe.
Do you know where I can find some straws?
I don't know. Are they near the napkins?
Are they near the napkins?
Repetition. Repetition means no.
Napkins?
Straws?
Milkshakes?
Soda?
Muffin?
Chicken?
Steak?
This is an
That's a pig,
where's
the right?
Did you ask Final Draft?
Who's Final Draft?
Am I on fire? Are you on water? How'd that work? Could it work? Probably.
Am I supposed to go first?
Where's the bell?
I don't know.
Yeah, we're awesome. complicated. Questions only. Fantastic. I don't need to run this. I'll just go home. You guys just do it. Okay, so team 1, team 2. Basically how it works is you'll step forward, you'll talk to each other, a little bit of dialogue, questions only. The audience gets to participate in this is too, because if they say a statement and they don't use a question, we all get to make a really obnoxious noise. You know what that noise is? Yeah, okay. And then you switch off with your partner and keep going, and we'll time you, and if it whittles off or you run out of time, I'll cut in. Be obnoxious.
Oh yeah.
So big voices, can you lift your microphones? Project one to hear. Cancel. Yeah, okay. Alright. So you guys are Everfree. Yeah, you're trying to look for your panel. Whenever you're ready. You're trying to look for your panel. Okay, ready? Go.
Where's the panel?
Man, it could be there, but I'm not sure. What do you think?
That's
kind of that ended in a question.
The audience has
spoken.
Oh, Sailor, it's your turn.
Has Anypony seen the panel?
Yes.
I don't know. Are you?
Me?
You?
Are you still?
I am.
We're gonna find donuts!
We are?
Now I'll give you over to the lovely princess, and whose line is it, Anypony?
You come up, you dance like monkeys, we laugh. That's pretty much how it works. We've got categories, so normally it's like, you know, everything's made up and the points don't matter, which is sort of true. Except that our judges are here. We've got, you know, Sweet Belle, Sweetie, and my lovely sister Lena, who will be judging you on how funny you are and how much the audience is laughing. At the end of the 4 regular rounds, we will basically bring up the 4 funniest people to dance extra for us. It's not making you dance like monkeys, it's fun. Woo! So without any more delay, I'm just gonna pull up 4 people. So you have to come on.